So, you know, in some of your workshops, I've seen you talk about, you know, turning businesses into like selling machines without sales calls, or self-selling machines, I should say. Like, what even convinced you that was possible? And then if that, like, if does is it possible? And then do what types of businesses are you usually promoting to do that?
Yeah, really, this is something I'm pushing really heavy right now. It's called an AI smart website. Okay. What I've noticed is with basic brick and mortar businesses, by the way, when I say that, I just mean like law firms, HVAC, you get what I'm saying, service businesses. Yeah. There's a couple core things they need to run their business. Obviously, you got to have contacts coming in and out. You got to have some sort of form of reputation management, which is local SEO. Yeah. And then basically 24/7 sales and support. And then a place to find people. And with an AI smart website, which I've already built these out. They're prepackaged, done for. You can have them for free on my YouTube channel. When you go there and you plug that in through a snapshot, you can basically have the AI voice agents to answer sales calls and customer support 24/7, no holidays. You have the text-based support that's WhatsApp, text, email, you know, all the text you could possibly want. And then the website with the forms and everything to capture them. So just from that alone, you can pretty much solve all of their problems. And you can set that up in under 5 minutes. I've even timed myself.
Well, and I mean, I would say for most companies, they're not even doing some of that. So even having it would be better than nothing.
Yes, yes.
Hypothetically, if you had someone who was doing those things all with humans versus the AI, like, would the AI be 80% as good, 90%, 50%? Is it hard to say? Does it vary?
It's getting better, dude.
Really?
It's getting to the point where it's literally better than humans.
Interesting.
Because a big thing I've realized, and when I talk to people, I have to like explain this to them. I will be like, hey, you know, the AI agent, this will go in the answer sales calls. And they might be like, hey, this isn't going to be as good as a human. Well, it's like, it's not going to be as good as maybe Sally, your best rep you've ever had. But Tim, Mary, and all the rest of the people you had that sucked, it's going to be better than them. And I think that's the mistake people make with AI is like right now, even though it's getting better, it's like the vast majority of humans doing customer support, not a knock on humans, but they don't really care about their job. That's the sad part. It's like the AI does. It's going to do whatever you ask it.
Yeah. So, I mean, when you're helping businesses with this, I guess I don't know even if like you can control this because you're just the one setting it up. But like, how can you make it so it sounds less robotic, more human-like? Is it just kind of giving the AI time to catch up, or is there something you can actually do as you're setting it up that's like, I don't know, for example, you could say like, hey, make sure, you know, you pause after this, or like if you're messaging someone, follow up, you know, 3 times within a 24-hour window. I don't know, like, I'm just trying to think out loud, you know, because some people probably who are listening to this might go, oh, I don't know, like, it's going to sound robotic. And like, I don't know what things they would say, but sometimes people will say like, oh, it pauses too long. Or if it's a DM, it says something weird and generic. Like, I guess, like, is it just giving AI time to catch up, or is there actual stuff you do that it's like makes it more human-like, so to speak?
Yeah, this is a question I get so often because people complain. They're like, oh, it's not first. They're most likely using something outdated. That's the first thing. The second big thing is, it's self-learning.
Oh,
so it'll take FAQs, it'll put it in the database. Basically, all you have to do, especially for high levels AI agents, is you first have to pick your voice, which they have an amazing 11 Labs partnership where
I'm familiar with 11
and the voices sound amazing. I mean, you can get almost, I mean, there's a voice called German scientist.
Yeah.
Like, who the hell needs a German scientist? But that's the concept. But then you have just some basic prompt engineering that anyone can do if you have ChatGPT. Yeah. And from there, you're getting something that sounds amazing.
Yeah. So with 11 Labs, at least what I've heard in there, I know there's other companies, but to me, it sounds good enough to do customer service, but like, I'm not sure if it's quite, maybe even set calls. I'm not sure if it's quite there yet for a full sales call, like a 60-minute call. Would you agree with that? Or
I would agree with you. Okay. It's not, well, it depends on what you're using. If you're using the most advanced thing, maybe. I think the only problem is it might be able to do one, but to get to do it again and again, maybe not, but it will get there.
Yeah. No, 100% I agree. Just a matter of time. I think, even in 10 years, my brother-in-law does a lot of coding, and I think, I mean, it's going to change the game where, like, in 10 years, it's going to be so easy for anyone to code. Like, I almost feel like it might make the tech space similar to info where, you know, anyone can, like, launch a course, anyone can launch an app, and that'll be interesting because right now there's a higher barrier of entry. Even with AI now, it's like you still need some developers and stuff like that. I think in 10 years, potentially, you know, you'd be like, yeah, I want to make this app and it does this. And like, there'll be
100%.
You know, it'd be interesting to see, to be quite honest. Well,
that's what I've been telling everyone on YouTube, on my live streams. I'm like, get in on this now.
Yeah. Because
there's going to come a point where everyone has the same weapons, dude. And you cannot compete with that.
It's you've been in business, what, how long now? About five years.
Yeah,
so it's interesting because I'm in year 8, and to actually see an economic cycle where, you know, I started like around 2017, and you know, just from now, from then to now, you know, ads are a lot more expensive. It's a lot harder. There's less trust. It's interesting because now that I've seen it, I'm like, oh, this is why people go out of business, because most people, once the economy changes, they don't adjust. And so kind of like what you said, it, people are adjusting now, and then in 10 years, you got to do it again. And then you got to do it again. And I think the killers will do it, but a lot of people won't. And I think that's why they go out of business. So you've shared strategies from what I saw for like unlimited leads using high level and outreach methods. What would you say is your top lead gen channel right now?
Dude, this is such a good question, because one of the interesting things I'm seeing, and I'm telling everyone, I'm prepping them. I think that in the very near future, and it's already happening now, but in-person and tangible marketing will only get bigger and bigger, because no one trusts anything on online anymore. I mean, you've probably seen these Jake Paul videos. You literally can't. It looks real. With the AI chatbots, all of the stuff that's going to happen with the email market, everything, people are not going to believe anything digital. Yeah, maybe there's some verification system, but what's going to happen is like networking, you know, I hate to say door knocking, but door knocking, in-person things, you know, direct mail campaigns. I'm telling you, man, because everyone's going to shut off parts of like the, I don't believe this, when if they can get stuff physical, I think it's going to crush. I think, because I'm already seeing a lot of students in my community that are like going out and doing stuff like that, like maybe a door-to-door networking.
So really, you're killing it. Interesting. So your answer to that question is actually doing more kind of human-like
100%
manual effort. Interesting, because really.
Because people, especially, you've seen this too with the info space. People don't believe marketers anymore.
No, like, bro, the trust is at an all-time low. In fact, like I would say now, you know, I've moved, I have other businesses and companies, et cetera, but like, I mean, you got to do a 5-day challenge. You got to do all these lives. You got, I mean, you got to add in all this stuff, because like they just don't, you know, watch a VSL, book a call, buy anymore.
Nope.
They just don't.
And it's only going to get more like that.
Yeah, that's interesting.
And if you can go in person, I've seen this with my students. Like I have testimonials on YouTube of this exact thing. They go in person and it's like the walls, the trust is like, the wall's down and the trust is immediately there.
What's the pitch on average? So I'm an agency owner. I go into a local brick and mortar business, knock on the door, walk in. Is it just more like, hey, I will do this for you for free, and then at the end of 30 days, like, what would be the average pitch?
You immediately demo. Show, don't tell. This is, again,
interesting,
and this is not me just hyping myself up, but I have, in the high-level space, more testimonials and case studies than anyone else. And there's a reason for this, because I give them the exact stuff that worked for me. And one of the things that I go over with everyone is I'm like, stop using pitch decks. Stop trying to use some weird sales deck, because it's outdated. People just go, okay, we've heard this before from the other 1,900 marketers that hit us up. I tell them, show, don't tell. Pull up an AI chatbot, put their number in, start having it work right there. Have them call it right there, or you can do this over Zoom, however you want it. Have them really see how it will work for their customers. And then all you have to do is go, listen, dude, I'm not even asking for money. Take it for free, 14 days, try it. And here's what's interesting. If you can solve a real problem on a free trial, not a like a, okay, you're in this heat grid on SEO, like you really helped them.
Yeah.
You then, all you have to do is just turn off what you have on and they will come to you. And then the ball's in your court for the sales. And I say this, I know Hermosi has that whole saying, I know he didn't make it up, but you know, give people an offer so good.
I have
a saying that is, give them a service so good that when you leave, they will kill themselves. I know that's very dramatic. Oh, I'm visceral, man. But the concept is very interesting, because if you have their phone or their, you know, their phone lines being answered, you have their text being answered, you take care of all of that stuff. As soon as your free trial ends and you are actually solving their problem, what's going to happen? Are they just going to go, okay, now let's pay the guy we just fired to answer, or I'm going to take all this time? No, it's immediate pain. And that's, I'm telling you, that's what I've been having everyone do, and it's been crushing.
Do most of these businesses not have anything set up, or would you say they have stuff set up and it's like, this is better? I'm assuming most don't even have a setup.
They don't, or they have one person working.
That's crazy,
that's
bro.
Just not, I mean, that's the opportunity though, Tanner, is so many people aren't doing it.
Yeah.
But on top of that, the people that are doing it, it's terrible. I mean, we have big, big electrical companies near me, and there is so many problems. I'm like, oh, the weekend, my lights went out. You call them, no one answers. Just having an AI chatbot on the weekends. If you don't even want to fire your employees, just the weekends.
Yeah.
Dude, that's got to be six figures in sales a year just from that, because you're missing out on all that stuff.
Yeah, it's interesting that you say that, because like a lot of times with the experience I've had in business now, I always think, man, if you can take internet marketing skills and move them into non-internet marketing businesses, it crushes because it does, yeah. they don't do any of it.
Yep.
Like it's like foreign to them in an industry where, you know, I'm like, oh yeah, this is like common sense. It's just crazy to see how many businesses they don't have like simple setups. Like, I mean, even you're talking about AI, but just like even just doing it like a text automation, like just that, like not even AI where it can think, it's just like, do you have simple setups? It's crazy to think how many businesses don't have it, and you just add it in and they get an immediate ROI just because of that.
Immediate
right?
ROI is the key point there.
Yeah.
People look for things that take forever and then no one buys their
Yeah.
Go for the immediate and you'll sell way more people.